Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another festive holiday edition of the Wellness, the Shape America Physical Activity Council Wellness Wednesday series. We are so pleased that you're here with us tonight, whether watching live or watching at another time. We are once again also welcoming back Cheryl Waddell. Cheryl, thank you so much for joining us on a wonderful, right now in New York, it's snowing, but thank you for joining us again. How are you tonight?
I'm great. It's raining here, not snow.
Right, Cheryl? You were telling me you have some new fun activities for us tonight. Do tell.
Well, yeah, you know, with the holiday coming, I don't know. I thought it would be a great time to do a little bit of functional fitness. I go to a gym called Adapt. It's kind of changed things for me. Think athletics meets physical therapy. So great for kids. I start with it kindergarten all the way through coaching through high school, college. So without further ado, I'm going to get started. You're just going to follow me. I'm going to start with the simplest routine and I'm just going to build up from there. Let's get some different music. There we go. All right, first one, we're going to stork walk in place. Historic walk, you can let your arms hang. We're going to do each thing about 10 to 20 times. All right, next one, that was historic walk. Next is a dragon push-up. We're going to have everything in 90 degrees. You're going to tip forward like a teapot, put your chest towards the ground, come back up. You want to squeeze those shoulder blades together. So not a modified push-up, but keep your hips at 90 degrees. And tip forward, we're going to do about 10. If you're an overachiever, I guess you can do 20. We'll start with about 10 of these. And one more. So trying to get that chest down. Nice job. Next one's an active turtle bridge. So active tricep bridge. You want your feet out. Everything's going to be 90 degrees. Come up to that bridge. Touch the ground and up. Here we go. Up and down. Up, down. Up, down. Up and down. That's it. Just bring hips up. So you want to tighten your glutes on top every time. That's it, up and down. Hips up, down. Up, you want to have your fingertips facing your shoes. That's it. Next one is gorilla glide. Or with the littles, you could call it gorilla glide or a spread foot glide. Feet are spread out, knees are locked, bottom tight. Now I'm going to come down and I'm going to glide across. Bend one knee and then the other. Lock your hands down in the middle. They should be in line with your toes. So as I glide back and forth, I want to make sure that my hips stay even. So I don't want to make rainbows. I want to glide my hips straight back and forth, trying to stay low. Keep going back and forth. And five more. Five, four. Three, lock that knee, two, one. Good. Next one is called a downward dog squat. So I'm gonna come down, cat and dog position. We think in 90 degree angles a lot here. So I'm in that 90 degree angles. I curl my toes under. I'm gonna come up to downward dog and then back down. Just up and down. Up, down, up, down. Back and forth. So lock your knees on top. Try to push those heels to the ground. Pause on top. And right back down. Up, down, up. That's it. Lock your knees and pause on top. Push those heels towards the ground, even if they don't want to touch. We're going to do five more. Five, four, three, two, one. All right, we've done five different ones. Number six, you could call with the little just an elephant lunge, or it's just a static pullover, and we're gonna do lunges. So I'm gonna lunge down, then I'm gonna step back, switch legs, up. So I'm gonna big step, drive the back knee straight down and back. Back and forth. That's it. All right, keep going, lunges. And this one you don't need to do 20 of, you might just do five each leg or around 10. All right, so that's our first one. It's a great warm up. It's got six exercises and it's functional because I hit every part of the body. All right, next one. This one's gonna be similar, but we're gonna do eight exercises this time. So here we go, we've got knee to chest. Pull that knee up each time. You're just pulling up and hugging. Up, knee up, give it a hug at your chest. Up, that's it. Knee to chest. Knee to chest. Next one is gonna be called a standing active clock. I'm gonna bring those arms up. Let's see if I get back up. I'm gonna go that, 6 and 12. So straight up, we're gonna do about 10 of them. Two, just bring those arms, lock your elbow is what's important. Warm up that upper body. That's it. Let's do five more. Five, four, three, two, one. Next one would be that 10 and two position. So we come out to 10 and 2, back to 6 o'clock. So 10 and 2, up. Try to keep those elbows locked. Your thumbs should point behind you. That's it. Relax your lower body. Up to 10 and 2. Drop your arms and do it again. That's it. So this is working those shoulder blades. So you can think about squeezing those shoulder blades together when you get on top. Next one, 9 and 3. Here we go. Back and forth, you're gliding those straight. Make sure you have your shoulders dropped down. Don't want them up by your ears.
Oh, absolutely.
That's it. That's it. Now, our next one is just gonna be a static lunge. So we're gonna do five each leg. You can do 10 each leg, but we're gonna do just five this time. So you're gonna do a big wide step. You wanna tighten the glute. When I go down, I wanna drive that knee straight down. So big enough step. Two,
you wanna bring it up.
Almost touch the knee. That's it. One more time. Good, switch feet. Big wide step, tighten your glute on the back side, drive your back knee straight down, up and down, that's it.
Obviously.
All the way down, good. Next one is gonna be a sitting active diva. So diva, funny name, huh? I know I'm black on black, it's great when I'm on the white, but your front leg, your knee is bent, your foot is touching your other knee. Then my back foot, I want it away from my hip a little bit. And I'm gonna try and sit up as tall as I can. Now, I'm gonna actively pick up my back knee. I'm trying to keep my left bottom cheek on the ground. So you wanna sit as straight as you can. Back knee up, down. If it doesn't go very high, it's okay. If you can't lift it all, just pretend. So you're engaging that hip right there. So we're working on some joint tracking, okay, some muscular health here going on. So knee up and down. Good, we're gonna switch sides. So you're gonna again bend the front knee at 90, back knee is bent. That front foot is gonna touch, almost touch the front knee. Sit up tall first. Good, nice and tall. Now pick up your back knee, up and down. Oh, this one's harder for me. Keep that cheek on the ground. So you wanna try, when you're real inflexible, I always tell kids I coach, you look like the letter C. So the straighter the better, but whatever function your body has is okay. So instead of forcing our body into function, we're trying to do exercises that are gonna help it function. That's it, we're gonna do a couple more. All right, up for that, spread foot wide, feet wide. So you can see similarity between these two. This one's just a little bit more advanced. Feet wide, hands in the middle, bend one knee and then the other. One knee and then the other, back and forth. So you're trying to glide your hips low. See if you can get down a little bit farther each time. Keeping the hips low in the middle, lock that knee, pause. I tend to go too fast. Pause and then switch. That's it. All right, next one. A lot of you know this one. It's gonna be an inchworm. I'm just gonna inchworm down, turn around, come back. So I'm gonna walk my hands out. Walk my feet up to my hands and stand up and go the other direction. Inchworms. Walk those hands out. Walk your feet to your hands. And back the other way. And switch again. So inchworm, you're gonna walk it out. Keep your legs straight as you walk them to your hands. One more time. Okay, next one is a reverse pullover. So I'm gonna take my hands, I'm gonna put them behind me. You see that? Then I'm going to make sure my shoulders are wide open. I'm gonna lift up and down. Now again, if you got big biceps, like I don't, you might struggle to get them up very high. Up and down. Up and down. Lock those elbows. If you're just stuck, when you're locked, that's okay, just hold it. If you can, lift it up a little bit. Good, up and down, keeping your elbows locked. I'm trying to get to open this back up. All right, last one for this round is gonna be full squats. Hands behind your head. You're gonna come down and stand up. Now in this full squat, sit back like you're gonna sit in a chair and stand up. You can even leave your arms at your side. If you have any neck pain, you're just gonna sit back and up. We're doing full squats. Good. You can go down however far is comfortable. When you come up to the top, make sure you press your hips forward. Give it a little pause, a little squeeze on the back side on top, and keep going. One more. All right, so that's kind of the intermediate step. Now that you should feel all warmed up, we're gonna do a couple Tabatas. So again, what I'm trying to think is different directions. So if I use my front side, using my back side, and if we're, I don't want all my motions just going forward, I'm gonna try and add some side and maybe even some back to back. So next step is into our Tabata. So we're gonna do four exercises, repeat. First one is gonna be, it's like a stork walk, but we're gonna add arms. Next step is to add a skip. Go. So we go up with that arm. Drive. If you want to add a skip, you can, or you can just march. Your choice. It's only 20 seconds, so we're going. Next one is a jumping jack. Here we go. Jumping jack. So I'm using both sides of the body. Next one is going to be a skater. So when I skate, I need to bring that foot, pause, and then try to go nice and wide. Go. Nice and wide. One's going to be a stork walk to a backward lunge. Up, back, switch feet. Switch each time. Stork walk, step back in the lunge. Switch feet. Stork, lunge. Stork, lunge. Stork, lunge. Stork, lunge. Keep it going. You're almost halfway. Good. And a repeat, we're going right back to our range of motion skip or march.
3, 2, 1.
Here we go. So picking it up, the speed maybe a little bit, second round, second half. Jumping jack. Modify is a step instead of a full jump. Go. Some water. Make sure you grab some water if you need it. That song is called Tabata Kids. It's an album created by Pete Dristel, who's a PE teacher back east. So I love it because it counts. I don't have to think. I know how long counts down so that I don't need a timer or anything. So great job. All right, we're going to go into some more of the exercises and then a cool down. Okay, next one, we're gonna do less. You could do up to 20 of each one of these exercises, of these ABCs. We're gonna start with the standing elbow curl. Elbow curl looks like this. A lot of these exercises I'm sure you've never done before. You can put your fists at your temple, thumbs down. Touch your elbows if you can, as far as you can, and back and forth, elbow curl. Okay, we're going to do about 10. Again, you could do up to 20 of those in a row. Works. Feet wide. Okay, hips tight, bottom tight, knees locked with the reverse pullover you did before. So this is a spread foot, reverse pullover. Keep those shoulders down. Try to see if you can get your shoulder blades to come towards each other, lifting up and down. Next level, push those hips out a little, hips, heels out farther than your toes. What does that do? It gets in a different angle for your hip. You're using some of those small muscles you don't normally use. All right, next one, I'm like, something is missing. It's called music. So let's turn a little more music on. It's always more fun with music. Rotational stork walk. Knee comes out and around. Relax your arms. Bring it first out, 90 degrees, bring it around. So make sure you take time to initiate it from your hip, not your knee. Let your shoe or your toe hang and relax. Hips, we're trying to work these hip flexors. Those things that are sitting way too much right now. Any one of these three routines could be a great reset for you after you've been sitting, taking the 6, 8, or 12 exercises, and you can combine them, okay? As a good break from sitting. It can make you feel a lot better. It's gonna make you more functional. When you do something like run, you've got your body awake and out of sitting in that cast position. Okay, spread foot wide, you know this one, feet wide, hands in the middle, bend one knee, then the other. Back and forth. That's it, back and forth. One side, then the other. Bend one knee, lock out the other knee, and glide. That's it, back and forth. All right, we've got an overhead extension, again with a lunge. We're gonna do, this time we're gonna do 5 one leg, 5 the other. Big step, drop that knee, down 5. Try it, you can go ahead and touch the ground if you lightly tap it. If you feel pain, stop before that. After 5, switch feet, big step. Lock, tighten your bun on the backside first. Then straight down with that knee. That's it. Suddenly somebody changed my balance. All right, next one. First time you've been on the ground, you're gonna do what's called an active twist. Well, all the way on the ground. You're gonna put your feet wide apart, knees bent. Okay, now I'm gonna twist both knees to the right. You're gonna tighten your left cheek, bum cheek, palm. Up and switch. Okay, once you feel that, feet wide, knees bent, you can just go, take a slight pause on each side. Both knees rotate to one side. Keep both shoulders on the ground. Don't let your arms come up. You can't go any farther than just stop. But if your shoulders have to lift off the ground, you've gone too far. Back and forth. Good. Back. It's called active twist. One of my favorite movements, one of my athletes' favorite movements. Okay, we're going back to that active tricep bridge. Hands behind you. Good. Feet on the ground. Up to bridge. Touch. Active means we're moving. Up, down. Up, down. Good. Back and forth. That's it. Try to keep your weight evenly in your feet. Try not to lift up your toes in this one. Squats, you want all that weight in your heels. On this, you don't want to let your toes come up. Good. All right, we've got the downward dog squats. Hands on the ground, 90 degrees. Everything's 90, cat and dog position, okay? Curl the toes under, hips up, lock it out, and downward dog, back down. Pause on top. Right back down. Notice when I come down, everything's at 90 degrees again. I don't want to shift my weight around or have my arms way out in front of me. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Good. Arm circles are next. Feet hip width, arms out. Again, let those shoulders drop. Now, you're gonna make a think, Envision a circle all the way around your shoulder joint. So you go behind your shoulder, above, below, and forward. Good. Now, I'm gonna put my hands over and go backwards. Thumbs facing back, other directions. Good. Awesome. Just keep circling. Okay, full squats. Heels stay, hip width again. I'm gonna come straight down and back up. Down, up. Down, up. Down, up. Now, here's where you want your weight in your heels, not in your toes. You don't want your knees going way forward. So sit back like the chair is just an inch too far. So lead with your hips. Hips back and then down. Good. Awesome. We're gonna do a couple things to finish our cool down. That was our sequence of 10 exercises. We're gonna do a few more things to cool down some more. So come on down to the ground. We do a backstroke. One arm up, just like your backstroke. And switch. Good. Back and forth. One hand and the other. Why would we do this? Because we're working the whole body. The whole body works together. The spine is one joint. So you might be doing legs that day, but you're gonna wanna use your upper body also. All right, so again, these work good as warm ups or cool downs too. You're gonna do a pullover. You're gonna put your hands together, lock out your elbows, down to the ground, back to your legs. Good. That's it. Okay, next one. You're going to pick up your knee, straighten your opposite leg. So you can just hold it right here. I'm going to rotate it so it comes over on my stomach side. I'm going to leave this shoulder on the opposite side down. Now you're going to see that my knee, I do not have flexibility in my spine. I actually love this one. So you're gonna hold this. You can do 30 seconds, you can do a minute. But the key is, hand on the ground on opposite side. This hand can give a little more weight to let that knee drop more. And then you can look back at the opposite hand and just lay there. Make sure this knee stays up at 90. All right, switch sides. Other knee comes up. Opposite hand on your back side, opposite arm, bring your knee over towards your front side. Remember to leave that shoulder on the ground of the opposite. For me, I always get a nice crack in the back on this one. Hold it. All right, after we twist, you always, always want to do a pelvic twill, tilt, or something. So something to keep back up. So I'm going to arch. I'm going to flatten my back. As I do that, you're going to see my head pull up and down. You should feel kind of your hair, your head, if you don't have any hair, go up and down as you do that pelvic tilt. Arch, flatten. Arch, flatten. Good. Right. I'm going to put my feet in frog. That means my knees are all the way out. My shoes, the bottom of my shoes are touching. Good. I'm going to do overhead pullover. So I'm going to put my hands extension. So I'm going to put my palms towards the ceiling. I'm going to put my hands together, lock my elbows. I'm going to go back and forth. But I'm just going to lay in this frog position. Okay, just relax in that position and let your arms do the work. A little stretch for your groin. Good. Excellent. Now, feet are wide. We're going to do an active frog that's wide. So knees in and out. Knees are bent. They go in and out. Awesome. Come on up. We're going to do a couple cats and dogs. So I'm going to be here. I'm going to drop head down. I'm going to look up in that dog position, then cat. I'm going to look at my knees and arch my back. It's also fine. hips flat. Just a few of these. Good. Before I come all the way up. All right, we're gonna end with just 5 squats for a finale. So I like to end with a wall sit or a squat. We'll go easy tonight since it's so close to the holidays. We can come down and up 5 times. Sitting down and back up.
Alexa, call my phone.
All right. So I hope that you have enjoyed this workout. It's not this part can get real intense, but this is not the most intense version, but it's very functional so that you're working on your muscular health and your joint tracking so that your body can be the best it can be and to counter all that sitting we're doing these days. Thanks for joining me.
Well, let me get my view. Oh, I muted myself. Oops. Thank you so much, Cheryl. Whew, that was quite the workout. We're going to have to, so just so you know, we're January, February, if you're available, love to have you, of course. Next week, just an audience programming update. I love saying that. We're not going to be having it. We're going to celebrate and wish you from the Shape PA Council and the Wellness Series a happy holiday. We will be back, though, on December 30th. My most very excellent friend, Jeremy Lardieri, will be doing we're calling it New Year's Fitness Commitment. And then the first week of January, the first one of January, your one and only guest host will be the host of the show. So thank you so much for joining us. Thank you, thank you. And as always, have a great night. And stay safe and stay active.